Welcome to Teach Tech 2, a YouTube channel that bridges the gap between intellect and science. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe us to remain updated with technical videos. Hello and once again welcome to our YouTube channel Teach Tech 2. This is our second video in our video series of quick crash course on RS package called Shiny. In our last video, we have already understood the basics of Shiny app and how to install it on RStudio, and we have performed some simple operations and we have understood the core of this Shiny package, how to use it. Now we'll move one step ahead and we'll see some practicals, how to run the operations on the given data set using Shiny and how to make an interactive data visualization with Shiny app. So before starting, let me tell you some important facts. Data visualization plays a vital role in the life of a data scientist. If you want to make your career as a data scientist, then data visualization is the most important thing that you need to be perfect in. It is easier to visualize complex data also and relationships than deciphering them from spreadsheets or tables. To visualize the spreadsheets and tables, that would be more easy to understand, and also the data scientist's role is to explain that data. To visualize that and to make people understand that is really very important for you if you want to serve to the clients also. There are several tools for visualizing data such as Tableau, Qlik, Diagraphs, Kibana, and many more. But if you talk about R, it provides three plotting systems which we are going to talk about in this video. The base plotting system, the lattice system, the ggplot2 system. ggplot2, we have already worked on that in our previous video, you must watch them. How to create a ggplot from the given data set. But writing codes for plotting graphs in R time and time again can get very tiring and boring, and you will get really frustrated. Also, it is very difficult to create an interactive visualization for story narration using the packages like ggplot, lattice, and base plotting system. So these problems can be solved by dynamically creating interactive plots in R using Shiny with minimum effort and best output. So if you use R, chances are that you might have come across Shiny, and if you use the Shiny package, then it would be like this gift for you. This box is filled with many utilities which can help you to make your career as a better data scientist, which will make you stand out of the other people, because it consists of, as we have talked in last video, HTML, CSS and JavaScript. If you are good at that, the best part about Shiny is that you don't need any knowledge of HTML, CSS or JavaScript to get started. So in this video, we'll go through some steps and we'll see some practicals of Shiny app and we'll understand them in deep. So let's begin. First, I'm opening a simple file which I will make you understand with. There are two files. One is this app, which is R file, and one is R workspace. So whenever I will store a file, it would get stored in this way. So I'm opening this app and we'll see that how this app works. This app is to create a plot. So when I will run this app, it will get open on RStudio like this. We also have another option to open this on the browser. I will open it on browser also, like Chrome or any other. There also it could be stored. So let's understand the simple code first of this small program that we have created, which is histogram of waiting times. So now let's create our first app on Shiny. For that, we need to import library Shiny. With this code, if you have already installed Shiny package on your RStudio, then you can just use this code and then you can work on Shiny library, which is the package on RStudio. The next step is define server logic for random distribution app. For your app, server function input output. So it will take from server input and output. Okay. Next, reactive expression to generate the requested distribution. This is called whenever the input changes. The output functions defined below, then use the value computed from this expression. So just check it. With this dereactive, it's created. Dist switch input dist norm equals to R norm, unif equals to R unif, For R, we need to just change with norm equals to R norm, unif equals to R unif, L norm equals to R L norm. So R is added on all these codes. EXP also REXP and norm also R norm. So this is created. Then test input $N. So with this code, we can just take the inputs on RStudio with Shiny package. Generate a plot. Now we want to generate a plot of the given data source. So for that also, we need to use the inputs to build the plot label. Note that the dependencies on the inputs and the data reactor expression are both tracked, and all expressions are called in the sequence implied by the dependency graph. So output $plot, render plot, this round bracket open, curly bracket open, and this complete work is done to create a histogram, which we are gonna see now when I will run this code. Color we have defined, border color we have defined, and these values we have given. Summary, this code is used to get the summary of minimum, maximum and all the basic stats of the data. So this summary of the data we can view. So all these things would be visualized with this small code, which is of R Shiny. Generate an HTML table. If I want to view the file on Chrome browser, so for that this would be done, and generate HTML view of the head of the data. And finally, to create the Shiny app, this code is used. Shiny app UI equals to HTML template www.index/index.html server. So I will just reload this app, and you can see it's got this output head generated. So distribution type, normal, uniform, whichever we will take, it would be changed. This graph will be get changed. Number of observations also we can select, and it will keep on changing. So it's not visible to me. What should I do? I should open it on my browser. When I will open it on my browser, it will get open. Now it's more clear and visible. So for a good data scientist, that's really a very good thing to be done, to visualize the data. Observations maybe 1000, then also we will get the result, and this kind of graph would be plotted on the given data set. Also, if I won't give any value, error, invalid argument, this would be generated. Like HTML files, if they may, on a site we visit, you can't leave the blocks empty, so this error, invalid arguments would be printed in the server. So this simple example we have seen. Now we'll see some more examples quickly and understand how we use this Shiny package. I will stop this file now. How to upload a file? I want to upload a CSV or JS, any other file format. So this app file which you're gonna create on this is R file. I am gonna open this file, and this is the R file, Shiny file, through which with this app you can upload a file, a CSV file, and you can visualize it as per your requirement. That's really a very good feature of this Shiny package. So I will run this app first. Its basic code is quite similar to the HTML codes. Title panel, it will print uploading files. App title would be that. Sidebar panel would be created. For horizontal line, text HR, we're gonna put this. Checkbox, radio buttons. You might be familiar with radio buttons. We have talked about that, their basics on last video also. But still, I will explain a bit to you when I will reload this app and print it. Its output, if you are going to view on browser or RStudio, I will just reload this app. So it's got created. Now, because currently it's empty, so nothing is displayed. The file upload we are going to do with this. So let me upload any random file from my desktop. Let's say advertising file I am taking. Within a second that file got uploaded on browser. Now if I want to view it on my browser, Chrome browser, I will just open it. It will get open. Again the same file I am uploading. My desktop, it's there. fine quality data file this time I'm taking. So here also there are variety of data of the quality of wine, and this data set is of advertising data, where how much expenditure is done by the company or the industry on various resources of advertisement like TV, radio, newspapers and sales. So what I can do with this, if I want to remove the header, can I remove it? I will just click on this header box, and what happened with this header removed? V1, V2, V3, V4 became V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Header was got removed. Similarly, I will bring back header once again, and I want to separate the values by semicolon, not by comma. So they would get separated by semicolon. You can see. Also, I can separate the files by tab. So they got separated by tab. These are all tabs. Quote, none, single quote, double quote, you can select as per your comment. Display all. So when I clicked on all the files got displayed, as you can see here. And if I will just click on head, only top few files would be placed on this browser, RStudio browser, or Shiny browser. Now another data that we had taken on Chrome, that also is more friendly. You can see it's quite friendlier compared to R. So if you're taking big data, then you can also visualize it on your browser. It's up to you, your comfort zone. So the same thing I'm doing here, I display all. So all the medical data of wine quality is shown. Around 2000 medicines data is there of these values of wine and their quality. You can just separate them by tab. You can see the change, this line got created. Click on semicolon, separated by semicolon, comma separated. This one is comma separated. The values are now comma separated. When I click on semicolon, it took some time because the file data set is a bit large one. That's why this happened. But I think semicolon is looking quite better. So whichever is comfortable, you feel comfortable with whichever to be displayed, you can choose that one. Quote also you can select here, double quote or single quote. The bigger the data is, the longer it will take time. But in fact, what matters is what is the best to visualize the data. So this output is created. It's really very good one, which seems to be the most decent one to visualize, and clear one to visualize our CSV file, which had some unstructured data which we had made as structured data, and fixed acidity, volatile acidity, citric acid, residual sugar, all these things that are there in the wines. Also later on we will see that if we want to select the files and the data among in the file which is having the maximum fixed acidity or maximum volatile acidity, with one click we can do that also. Maximum, minimum and all that thing could be done with Shiny package, which also we will see later on. So with this example we have seen how we can import a CSV file or any other type of file which we want to select. Now we are taking some data tables, how to take the data tables and how to visualize them. Here we need another package, it's called ggplot. For the diamonds data set we are going to use this package ggplot. So with this ggplot package we will get the diamond data set. examples of data set, basic codes we are running here, and naming the files, the empty cards, iris data, diamond data, iris data, and diamonds. Three data sets we are taking, different columns would be created. So how we can take three different data sources with this ggplot and we can just visualize them. So I will just run this app and show you. It got open. Now I will open this file on my browser so it would be properly visible to us. So it got open. Now we are also working here on search bar because there are three different data sources: diamonds, empty cars, and iris data set. So, and just like you visit e-commerce site, you might have visited, if you're watching this video, you have definitely visited e-commerce site like Amazon, Flipkart. So what you have observed there, on a single page there are multiple smartphones, and you can go on these 1, 2, 3, 4, and because it won't take much of your net speed and it won't take much time, so this kind of feature is added. So same thing is also there, which is applied on Shiny app also, through which with big data which we have and different types of data, three different data sources are here: diamonds, empty cards, and iris data set. So what feature we are working here is we can show entries as per our requirement. It could be 25, 50 or 100. So if I click on 100, we can see first 100 data. This data is of diamonds, where their carat, cut, color, clarity, depth, table, price, XYZ is given. So I can just want, if I just want to take the data of 100 diamonds, we can select that, only first 10 diamonds, then also 100. Same is the case with empty cards data set. So with ggplot, this data set is also that we have got, and iris data set, which is quite popular for machine learning algorithms, that data set of iris data set, here also we can select entries as per our requirements. Also here is search box. So let's say I want to take all the data source of with the color F. So if I will just write F here, so what I am getting in the result, all the text files which are having F, but better would be fair if I would write, and I will search it. So cut fair, all the values we have got in the result. I want to get only empty cars data, so for that I have just clicked here. For iris data set I have just clicked here also, but what we can do is I want to sort according to carat. So from lowest to highest, we can just by one click we can sort the values. Just sort the values and separate them as per our requirement. So DDDD as per the clarity, table in ascending or descending order, price. So I will just one click. Also this select column, we can just only, if I want only price and carat and nothing else, so I will remove everything and I will just let price and carat to be seen here in our file, price and carat. So only price and carat is visible here. Now that was all about diamonds. Similarly in empty cards, or iris dataset. We had done this only on diamonds dataset, so that feature is available on diamonds dataset. So let's see its code in quick way. Library shiny, library ggplot we had taken. UI we have created fluid page which with the example of database. So it's the name of this file. Sidebar layout we have created, and these three data sets as the input we have taken: empty cars, iris and diamonds, and checkbox group input we have given here the checkbox in diamonds. That's why this checkbox got displayed here while it's not in iris data set. Okay, so is the case with the other data set. So this is how it works. You can just download this code. I have given the link as per your suitability. So I think this is also clear to you. So remember, if we'll get a client will give us such a data set, and we can just visualize that data set and represent them and express them that the price of your diamonds were dependent on the amount of carat. The higher the carat value is, and the better the cut is on the diamonds, and the better the depth and clarity of the diamond is, its price is correlated with that. It's not necessary that the diamond which had highest carat, it would be sold at the highest price. Other features are also similarly important. So sometimes these kind of new things used to get in the as a result. So we have to convert data into information and information into knowledge, and these kind of things are done by data scientists. So that's why this profession is really of very importance in today's world. So that's how we use it, using RStudio and Shiny package. Now we are going to see an example of selectize plot, how it works. I will run this code. Here we are going to use the library maps. So first let's see how it works so you can understand it more clearly, and then we'll understand its code and functionality. Here's the data of the states of US, the crime rate, the murder, assault and rape cases, and how many number of arrests were done per 100,000 people. So it ranges from 0 to 350, and murder, assault and rape, that's the three cases in the x-axis, and in the y-axis the number of arrests. So how it's been done, I will just show you on my browser. We'll open it. Here it's more clear to visualize. We had two files here, server.r and ui.r. So this ui.r create plots in selective input, and this HTML visualization is being kept here. In server.r, the operation which we can perform on the given data set, it would be performed, and the PNG images would be created, which would be the visualization of the graphs, the tables that would be drawn. The library maps we are going to use here, which is used to mapping of the given data set, to map the data, it is used. So let's see it, how it works. Let's say I want to just get search any term, let's say Alaska. So Alaska got displayed here. Search bar is we can use this search bar here as per our requirement. Let's say California, but also we can just see with search bar. Now if I want to know in which state of US the highest number of murders were made, so I will just click on murder. Once I click, it's showing 0.8. that means least murders were made in which state? North Dakota. Once again I will click on murder, 17.4. so this time it's in decreasing order. So that means in Georgia, the maximum number of murders had occurred. If once again I will click on murder, the state with the least murders came. The country with the, sorry, the state with the most rape cases, if I will click on rape once, 46 in Nevada. In the state Nevada, the maximum number of rapes were done in US. Again, if I will click on rape, in North Dakota, rapes were also the least. Urban pops were done, maximum in which state? California, because it's a, you can say, quite urban state in US. So, assault is also done maximum in there. So, this is about the this columns and rows. Now, here also, we can just see the pie chart and this graph. And select any state as per our need. So let me select California. So we got California here. So the graph of California is drawn. The line, you can see this. So whichever state we are selecting, its line is been drawn. Let's say Florida, I want to check. Just click on Florida and see that New York State. It's located here. Nevada. Also, if the state with the least murder, that's North Dakota. So I will just see North Dakota's graph here. That would also be displayed here. So this is how it works. So in this example, we use the method session $register data object. Round bracket open close to register a data object in the shiny session, which we can retrieve via the URL. That this method returns mapper 1 here. There we update the selective input so that the choices can be processed on the server side. Server equals to true here. And we provide a custom rendering method via the selectize initialization options. The rendering method sends a query to mapper 1 with the query variable state, which takes the values of the options item.value. We also provided the filter function in session $registerData, which should return an HTTP response based on the data registered and the current request req. We can extract the query string from req $query_string and pass the state string. Once we have got the state name, we draw a map of the state as well as a pie chart of the urban population percent, which we have seen. Finally, the plot is returned as an HTTP response that has the MIME type, which is image, and we can just download that image. Tag in the selectize rendering method will get the requested image. So if I can just click on this, with single click, you can just see image. So that image would be downloaded as PNG image, whichever state's image you want, and you can compare it with other states in image form. So it's really very good feature of Shiny. So this app also contains a parallel coordinate plot, which is render plot, and a data table render plot that are straightforward to understand and how and should be familiar to Shiny users. Another data file that I'm taking here is telephones by region. So I will open that file also now, and I will run this app. And I will again open it on browser because its visibility is not clear to display it on YouTube. So Now we can select the region and we can get the data of number of telephones from the year 1951 to 1961. So let's say Africa. Or Europe. So we can directly take the data and convert that into the graphical form. How for that, which code we have used, just check this out. Rely on the world phones dataset in the datasets package, which generally comes preloaded, is library dataset. So here we have used the package library datasets with Shiny. So that dataset would be available to you when you will run this code. Now define a server for the Shiny app. Function input output, we're gonna take output dollar phone plot render plot. And to render a bar plot after this code, you have to write this code, bar plot world phones input dollar region into 1000. So input dollar region into 1000 would be done. Main equals to input dollar region, number of telephones and year. So number of telephones in y axis would be put, and in year would be put in x axis, which we are putting here x lab y lab with this code. And UI.R, here we are displaying this in the HTML form which had been displayed here. Its code is this library datasets from which we had taken the data. Telephones by region got displayed here on the top left, this one which you had seen in the last video, the basics of this, but I'm just revising you so that you can remember. Sidebar layout and region is put here. So the sidebar layout, we can just use this and directly that graph would be created, which you can save or you copy this image as PNG file. So we can say that we all know about the power of R for solving analytical challenges. It is without a doubt one of the most powerful analytical tools available to us as a data scientist, providing the ability to solve modeling challenges using a range of traditional and modern analytical approaches. However, the reality is that we can fit the best model and write the best code, but unless someone is in the business is able to use the insight we generate to make a better decision, our teams won't add any value. So how do we solve this? We can do that with Shiny, because Shiny is a web application framework for R. In a nutshell, this means that anyone who knows some R can start to build applications that sit in a web browser. It could be as simple as displaying some graphics and tables to a fully interactive dashboard. The important part is that it is all done with R. There are no requirements for web developers to get involved. Also, Shiny allows us to create true data products that go beyond standard business intelligence dashboards also. So we can define intuitive interfaces that allows business users to perform what-if analysis, manipulating parameters that enable them to see the impact of different approaches on business outcomes. So what can we do is, we can use this Shiny package and we can get industry ready to perform data science related operations. When it comes to Shiny for sharing insights, some of the most common uses that we see include presenting results of analysis to end users in the form of graphics and tables, allowing limited interaction such as selecting subgroups of the data, displaying current status and presenting recommended next actions based on R models, automated production of common reports, letting users upload their own data that can be viewed in a standard way.
If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe us to remain updated with technical videos.